Welcome back, students of 6th class. My name is Asif, your mathematics teacher. To learn and understand some questions from exercise 1A, friends, chapter number 1, number system, because we will start revision, friends. So this video is for the purpose of revision. So we will and we have taken a couple of questions from exercise 1A. As we know, friends, we all are, as I know that we all are conversant about all the questions and their points. Okay, now see, first question 3, write each of the following numbers in expanded form. So here, friends, question number 3 carries 6 questions, sub questions. So we have taken only one questions as 6 number. So once this understand, it will be very easy to solve all the sub questions of question number 3. So see, friends, once again write each of the following numbers in expanded form. So here, friends, look at here, the 9, 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crore, 9 crores, 10, 10 lakhs, 1000, 510. So first, see, friends, write the digits from left side. Here the 9, right, and see number of digits. See the number of digits except 9. Here the 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So we have to write the 7 times 0 with 1, friends. Remember, 1 2 3 4 5 6, this is 7, because, friends, expanded form means we have to write all the digits in their own position as a sum form. So now we have already written 9 here. That means the position of 9 in this number is written over here, 9 multiplied by 1 7 times 0. Okay, now see, come to the next digit 1. So and write here the write the plus sign and write the 1 and see, friends, number of zeros. No, sorry, see, friends, here number of digits except these two numbers, 9 and 1. Then we have to look for the numbers after 1. So after 1, how many numbers or how many digits? Here the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 1 multiply by 1 with 6 times 0, friends. Remember, friends, 6 times 0. And we have already done for digits 9 and 1. Okay, now see, the next one is 0. So 0 could be written as or 0, there is no matter at all, because 0 multiplied by anything is equal to 0, or we can write 0 multiplied by here the number of digits, whatever the number of digits after 0. Okay, so now see, friend, this could be written as, there is no matter at all, because 0 multiplied by something is always 0, or 0 is added to any number is the number itself. So we cannot write 0, there is no need to write down the 0. Okay, now see, the after this 0 we get 5. Now write the plus and 5. Now multiply by, and see, friends, number of zero, number of digits after this, sorry, here is the 0, friends. Now the terms is 1. So write this 1, multiply by how many digits after 1? 1 2 3 4. 4 times 0 with 1, friends. Now this is plus once again, so this is 0, avoid the 0. Okay, there's no need to write the 0 here. The C, 5 multiply by, friends, how many digits after 5? There are 2 times 2 digits, so 1 multiply by 2 digits. Okay, plus, friends, now come to 1. So write this 1, multiply by how many digits after this 1? Only 1. So 1, and if you come to the 0, so 0, there is 0, so there is no need to write the 0. So this is called the expanded form, sir. So the answer is this, friends. Now come to the next question, friends. This is question number 5. Find the difference between the place values of 2 nines. Place value of, now see, friends, question number 5, find the difference between the place values of 2 nines. So what about the place value, friends? Actually, you know, and we had already discussed in the previous classes in detail lecture. Okay, The place value of digit in any number is nothing but it is in nothing but to know the position. To know the position of the digit in the number. That means we have to know the position of 9, this 9 and this 9 in this number. Then find their differences. Okay. Now see, here is the 9, friends. Means first of all, write the place value of this 9. So the place value of this 9 is, friends, here is the, write this 9 and see number of digits after this 9, friends. After this 9, after this 9 means from left, we will go from left to right. Here is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 times, write down the 6 times 0, friends, with 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And then we have find the difference, then find, write the difference. And now see, friends, write this, the place value of this 9 is 9, and see number of digits after this 9, here the 2 digits, so write the 2 times and find the difference, friend, and we will get the answer. I hope you can do this question. We can subtract and you will get the answer. Now see, friends, next question 8. How many 7 digit numbers are there in all? It's very, very important question, very, very easy question, very important, very interesting question. Because some of the students will get always confused how to find this, how to find the answer this question. Very simple. And actually I have already explained taking the very beautiful examples in the previous video lecture. Okay, now see, friends, here in order to find the 7 digit numbers are there in all, that means is question ko agar main Hindi mein translate karu to iska matlab ye ho raha कि 7 डिजिट्स के कितने नंबर्स हो सकते हैं, 7 डिजिट के कितने नंबर्स हो सकते हैं. अगर स्टार्टिंग नंबर फाइंड करूं तो आप बोलेंगे द स्मॉलेस्ट डिजिट ऑफ 7, द स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर ऑफ 7 डिजिट इन 1 6 टाइम 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 सबसे स्मॉलेस्ट ये है. यहां से आप काउंट करेंगे, उसके बाद 1 0 0 0 0 दिस इज 1. हाउ मेनी, इस तरह से नंबर 9 9 9 9 9 9 7 टाइम 1 2 3 4 5 6 and this is 7. So friend, this is the smallest, so this is the smallest number of 7 digits and this is the greatest number of 7 digits and there are huge, there are many much more numbers in between them, and we have to count all the numbers. So it's very difficult task to count all the numbers, friends. It will take a lot of time. Maybe it will take 1 day, 2 day, or two hours, 3 hours and much more. So avoiding the huge times, avoiding, and we have to save the times. In order to save the times, we will find the technique how to solve the questions. Now first, there is very simple technique, okay, and I got the one technique. This is the new technique other than the book. If in order to find the 7 digit numbers are there in all, means first we had to write the first we have to write the smallest 7 digit number. So smallest 7 digit number is, friends, 1 6 times 9 and then multiply with 9. This is 9 1 9 1 2 3 4 5. So this is your answer, friends. You can find the direct answer. Now the second way to find out the solution this question according to the book, okay. Now first we have to write the greatest number of 7 digit, okay, the greatest number of 7 digit, the smallest number of 7 digits. Now write the first, the greatest number 7 digit, the greatest number of 7 digit is equal to 7 times 9, friends, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, okay. And now next, the smallest, write the smallest number of 7 digit, friends. So the smallest number 7 digit 1 and 6 times 0, friends, 6, okay. And the required number, friends, and the required number is how many numbers, means सेवन डिजिट के कितने नंबर्स हो सकते हैं? रिक्वायर्ड नंबर्स, वी कैन राइट द रिक्वायर्ड नंबर्स. तो रिक्वायर्ड नंबर्स मीन्स फ्रेंड्स, हियर टू राइट द ग्रेटेस्ट नंबर ऑफ सेवन डिजिट 1 2 3 4 5 6 माइनस राइट द ग्रेट स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर ऑफ सेवन डिजिट और नाउ देन ऐड वन एंड वी विल गेट फ्रेंड्स दिस इज नाइन सब्ट्रैक्ट दिस इज 9 1 1 1 0 0 0 0 9 1 2 3 4 5 6 एक दो तीन चार पाँच. सो दिस इज योर आंसर मीन्स. सो फ्रेंड्स इन दिस एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 एंड क्वेश्चन नंबर फ्रेंड्स 7 एंड वन एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज टू एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चन एग्जाम्पल नंबर 4 एंड एग्जाम्पल नंबर 3. These are the similar type of question. This is very very important question and very technical and very interesting question. This is the second way friends, as you explained according to the book. And now the trick that we have find the solution this question, only write the smallest number of 7 digit friends. Write the smallest number of 7 digit means 6 times 0 with 1, okay, 1 2 3 4 5 and 6, and multiply by 9 and we will get the answer. Okay friends, I hope you will enjoy with this video lecture friends. Now come to the next exercise friends, exercise number. Now see friends, exercise B, 1B, this is for revision only. So this exercise carries very simplest questions we can easily solve. And first see the fill in the blanks means we have to recognize or decide which number is smaller and greater, very simple, and write the proper sign like less than or equal, greater than and less than. Now see friends, and another next question, arrange the following numbers in descending order, and we have taken question number 1. So in this sentences, this sentence carries the 4 sub questions, so we have taken 10 number question, and these are the given numbers. First friends, we have to write the descending order, means we have to arrange the descending order. Descending, what does mean by descending order friends? Descending order means we have to collect the greatest number among these. The greatest number is friends, this is the greatest number. So we wrote the first, then the smaller number, and the smaller number is second this. So this is why we have written over here, and then the smaller than this number, smaller the third number, we can write here over here, then the smaller than this number. So this number is written over here, then the smaller than this numbers is here, then the last, this is the smallest number. So the greatest number, we will bring the greatest number first, and we will place the smallest number at the last, and we have to write this is greater than, greater than, greater than, greater than, or we can write the comma, comma, no matter, because we have already arranged the numbers in descending orders, means and every number is can be read from the left to right. That means first the left hand side, the first number should be greatest and the last number should be the smallest. So this is your answer friends. So similarly we can solve the questions. The next questions will arise the arrange the following numbers in ascending order. So in ascending order, suppose in order to manage the numbers in ascending order friends, this question is just vice versa of the ascending order, means we have to bring the first the smallest number, then the greater, then greater, and the last number should be the greatest, okay. So this will give the answer, I hope you can understand. So there is no problem at all in exercise 1B friends, so we can solve all the problems of exercise 1B. If you have any doubt, so please ask me or contact me. Now let's begin exercise 1C friends. Now see friends, we will start to revise exercise 1C, and the question number 1 says the number of persons who visited the holy shrine of Mata Vaishnu Devi during last 2 consecutive years was this and this. respectively. How many persons visited the shrine during these 2 days? Very simple question. कुछ पब्लिक, बहुत सारे पब्लिक्स हैं फ्रेंड्स, जो इतनी इतनी तादाद में वो लगातार 2 साल वैष्णो देवी के मंदिर विजिट करती है. ओके, तो इन 2 ईयर्स में, इन लगातार 2 सालों में टोटल नंबर ऑफ पर्सन फाइंड करनी है. मीन्स वी हैव टू ऐड दिस पर्सन प्लस दिस पर्सन. ओके, नाउ राइट एंड ऐड. आई होप यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड फ्रेंड्स. ऐड मीन्स दिस 7, 8, 9, 5, 0, 9 either a column or the, this is 8, start from right side, 9, 4, 6, 7, 9, 2, 1, add and we will get the value friends, and we will get the answer. Okay, now see the next question. Similarly friends, we can see the question number 1, we can see the question number 2, 3, 4, 5, 8 are, we can solve easily. Now see the question number 9, by how much is itna large than this number? Okay, that means we can very simple. Now friends, in question number 9, we have to subtract a smaller from greater. See question number 10, by how much this number is smaller than 1 crore? 1 crore se kitna chota? Means we have to, and question number 10 is subtraction, subtract their values. Now 11, what number must be subtracted from this to get this number? Means we have to subtract these 2 numbers, mean friends, this number, so this number is subtracted from this number. Okay, now see, the sum of 2 numbers is given, one of the given, the subtraction friends. Now see, we will solve question number 27. Then question number, friends, in question number 27 we have to multiply 14 meter and 16 centimeter by 8 friends. Okay, and we will get the answer. Now only we have to divide friends, sorry, in question number 27 we have to now see friends, question number 27 says for making 8 roses of the same size, 14 meter and 80 centimeter of cloth is needed. How much cloth will be required for each such trouser? Now see friends, in Hindi, 8 trouser banane ke liye 14 meter or 80 centimeter kapde ki zarurat hai. 8 trouser, okay. Now how much cloth? तो कह रहा है ऐसे ऐसे प्रत्येक ट्रोजर बनाने के लिए कितने कपड़ों की जरूरत होंगी पड़ेगी. ओके, सिंपल फ्रेंड्स. नाउ फर्स्ट, सिंस गिवेन फॉर 8 ट्रोजर वी नीड 14 मीटर एंड 80 सेंटीमीटर. ओके, इफ यू कन्वर्ट दिस ऑल इन सेंटीमीटर, देन 1400 सेंटीमीटर प्लस 80 मीन्स 1480 सेंटीमीटर. ओके, यानी 1480 सेंटीमीटर मीन्स वी नीड फॉर मेकिंग 8 रोजर्स एज 1480 सेंटीमीटर क्लॉथ. ओके, नाउ फॉर 1 ट्रोजर, सो नाउ फॉर 1 ट्रोजर वी रिक्वायर्ड 1480 डिवाइडेड बाय 8, सो डिवाइड दे देंगे. नाउ दिस इज 185 सेंटीमीटर इफ वी डिवाइड मीटर एंड सेंटीमीटर, बिकॉज द आंसर इज मीटर एंड सेंटीमीटर. Now we will divide by 100, we will get the meter, and this is 1.85 meter. Hence we can say this is 1 meter and 85 centimeter. So this is your answer friends. I hope you can understand. Now next question. Now once again friends, so please see, for making 8 trousers of the same size, 14 meter 80 centimeter of cloth is needed. How much cloth will be required for each such trousers? Means we have to find the cloths for 1 trouser. Okay, hence since for 8 trousers we need 14 meter and 80 centimeter. If we convert in meter into 1480 centimeter. Okay, now hence for 1 trouser we required we required 1480 divided by 8 means 8 से divide करेंगे और now we will get the answer in centimeter. So 185 after dividing this by 8 we will get 185 as a centimeter. Now if we change in meter then by dividing by 100 we will get 1.85 meter means 1 meter this is 85 centimeter. So this is your answer friends. Now next question is, now friends we can solve all the sums. Okay, this is your homework. If you have any doubt or confusion, so please ask me, I will reply. Okay, so please your homework, because there is a lots of questions. If you have any doubt, any confusion, so please ask me. Okay, the video is going to be big, so this is why. So this is homework exercise 1A, 1B and 1C. Okay, if you have any doubt, please ask me. Have a nice day.